Always low, low prices at Pahrump Valley Auto Plaza.
Lauren Grant, a nurse and COVID-19 survivor, thought she'd seen the worst of the virus until daycare texted her this photo of her 5-month-old daughter, Madeline.
Her hands and feet were blue. And so I went and picked her up, and I noticed that she was having some more rapid respirations.
Madeline, who had recently recovered from COVID-19, was transported to Cleveland Clinic Children's by ambulance.
It was absolutely terrifying. My first instinct as a mother was, what's going on? And my second instinct as a nurse is, she's not getting enough oxygen. And my husband and I were just sitting there sobbing because we just didn't know if she was going to make it or not.
Tests revealed Madeline's heart was inflamed and racing.
So normally for a baby, their heart rates are anywhere from 100 to mid-100s at rest. Hers was over 200, and it was going up to about 240 to 260.
Madeline was diagnosed with a rare COVID complication called multisystem inflammatory syndrome in children, or MIS-C.
A lot of the body's reaction to the previous infection causes it to ramp up and cause lots of inflammation and kind of get stuck.
About 24 hours after receiving steroids and an antibody therapy to reduce inflammation, Madeline's condition improved.
She was smiling again. She was kind of moving around a little bit more, and it really kind of gave my husband and I some hope.
After 10 days of ups and downs in the hospital, Madeline is doing well at home. Her mom is encouraging parents to keep a close eye on their children, especially if they've recently fought coronavirus.
I feel like we were really lucky in that sense, that Maddie didn't have to be put on a ventilator. And I think from what I've read so far is catching this early enough so that it doesn't get to that point. And that's why it's super important to be able to recognize these symptoms in kids.
At Cleveland Clinic, I'm Erica Foreman.